There have been enormous changes, really, in this area over the last 10 years. 10 years ago, when you did an investor day at a major FTSE, which I was fortunate to be part of, when you'd get up to talk about sustainability, all the investors would use that as the opportunity to go for a coffee break. They didn't know the questions to ask. They certainly didn't see any point in it. All they really wanted to make sure was that you were going to deliver what you said you would deliver in terms of profit and returns to shareholders. And so long as this stuff didn't really get in the way, that was fine. And more broadly, I think, you know, 10 years has been a very, very long time on this issue. We knew then what we know now about both the seriousness and the urgency. But it's really taken the concept to start hitting everyday life, both in far-flung countries, but also countries much closer to us, for people to realise, actually, this isn't a future problem, it's a now problem. And to see figures ranging from Prince William to David Attenborough talking about the urgency. And in the last 2 years in particular, we've seen a seismic shift in public concern, activism by young people, not just in the UK, but all around the world. Businesses at least starting to try and work out what they need to do, although very few of them are acting quickly enough. And of course, that's great, but it's not enough because emissions are still going up. Plastic pollution is still going up. Biodiversity loss is still going up. Deforestation is catastrophically going up. So we're in that weird period where the last 10 years has shown a real shift. And in that 10-year period, it's really been the last 2 years. But investors still don't really quite know where to put their money and what good looks like. Consumers don't really quite know how they pick good over less good. And there's still a very long way to go and a short amount of time to do it in. I would urge now every SME in particular not to be put off by this subject, not to think of it as all downside, but to build their understanding of what their issues are. You can do that for free. Hunt around. Your trade associations will have free data. It will be all over Google. You do a search on it. Your big competitors will publish stuff that will give you enough of an understanding of understanding what your impacts are. Understand what you need to do to address those impacts. Think about the full scope of your business, but crucially, act and recognise that every single one of us in our personal and our professional lives need to take action now. So don't let great be the enemy of the good. Don't think you haven't got the money. Don't think that this can't, if you do it well, actually build you a better business. Don't think about this as, I carry on doing what I'm doing and I'll be okay, because you won't. Whether it's that you won't be able to employ people, or the government will put taxes on you that you're not ready to accommodate, or a competitor will come along that's doing a better job than you at being responsible and dealing with these issues, who will steal on your market share. I don't know which of those will hit which businesses, but I can tell you 100% with certainty that the market forces are shifting at a completely unprecedented pace. And despite the fact there's very difficult trading conditions at the moment, doesn't take the imperative for action on this away. And if you don't act, your business will be very vulnerable. If you do act, you can build resilience and possibly even growth at the expense of less responsible competitors. So why wouldn't you want to do that?